Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the A-B testing. Let's start. A-B testing is the process of comparing two versions of same test. If you want to compare the web pages or you want to compare the emails or you want to like do some testing of marketing assessed and by using those testing you measure the difference in the performance. You want to test the web page. This is your web page and here you mention the free sales. This is your web page and you want to test this web page and you want to test that this web page will perform better in terms of user experience or not. So what you will do, you will create two web pages, A and B. This is your first web page, this is your second web page. So in this way you will compare the two versions of same test. It means this is your web page. What you will do, you will create a two different version, version A and version B. What you will do, you will compare these two versions. By using the comparison you will get some result. So why using that, you will get the performance, how these both web pages are performing. So on that basis you can find some results or you can get some analysis. So this is called as a A-B testing. So in the A-B testing, we take two different version of the same test. This is your test. What you will do, you will do a different versions A and B of a same test. This is your email. So what you will do, you will create a two different version of the same email. This is email. Hi, I hope. So this is your email. So what you will do, you will create hi in all in caps, I hope all in caps. The second email you will create hi, I hope. So this way what you will do, you will create a different version of the same email and you will send these email to different set of users, and by doing that you will get some acknowledgement or you will get some results. By doing that you will get some analysis how these email is performing. So we will discuss by some other example how this behave. So for a time being you can understand that in the A-B testing, what we do, we do testing of a same test by using a different versions. This is A version, this is a B version. If B want to test more than versions, this is your test, you want to test XYZ anything, so what you will do, you create version A, version B and version C, or version N version. So this way this is called as a multivariate testing. This is called as a multivariate testing, or we can say that the ABC testing or ABCD testing. So this way most of the times be called like ABC or AB or ABCDE or a multivariate testing, and sometimes we also called as a split testing. How does A-B testing work? You are running one online retail chain and in the next month is a festival season. So for that you want to run one campaign or promotional offer where you want to send email to the different users. So what you will do, you will ask to your web team create an email which will have a different versions. This is your version A, this is your version B, this is the email A and this is your email B. Contents are same except here they mention the free. So in the subject, you will mention like this only in the subject of the email, but in the subject what you will do, you will mention this, and also in the subject you will mention this like free, then buy two get one free, but here you only mention buy two get one. So this way you will send these mail to different set of users. So what you will do, there are 10,000 registered users in your website. So what you will do, you will send A mail to 5,000 users and B mail to 5,000 users. So after that what you analyze, that mail A, when you send mail A to the 5,000 user, so out of 5,000 only 3000 users read the mail. And out of 3000 users, only 1500 users landed that particular website by using that particular email. It means conversion rate is 50%. How it comes 50%? Let's 1500 divided by this 3. So you will get 50%. Same way here, this B mail also sent to the 5000 different set of users. So what you analyze that out of 5000, 2500 users read that particular mail, and out of 2500, 2100 users landed that particular website by using that particular email. It means conversion rate is 84%. So it means if B sent this particular email which has a template B, that template is performing well as compared to the template A. So what the company will do, company will create a template B and send this template to all users. Let's in that particular website they have 1 million registered users. So what they will do, they will send this template B to 1 million users. So why in that, they can understand that their conversion rate will be better as compared to the template A. So this way we perform the A-B testing. Why company should do the A-B testing? So why in that, we can take appropriate decision after A-B testing, which can also boost our sales. As we had discussed in our last case, why in that, if we send a template B mail to all users, in this way we can boost our sales during the festival season. So we can boost our sales. A-B testing let us know what words, phrase, image, video or testimonials or any other element work best. Let's, this is your website, okay. You want to test this website, you want to test the A-B testing of this website. So what you will do, you will create two different set of versions, A version and V version. So in this version you can use some different words, here you can use some different words. So same phrases, like some formatting, what the subject, what is the subject area, what are the subject B are going to mention in this particular version A, what are the subject B are going to mention in version B. Subject means subject line would be same, but the like formatting little bit different. Like what image we are going to mention here, what image we are going to mention here. So we need to perform different set of versions, like version A and version B. But we cannot perform all the things at a one goal. So what we will do, we will create a one first variation. In the first variation, we will take variation A and variation B, where we will only set the words. So after that we will analyze what is the conversion rate. Then again, if we get X word is performing better, so we will choose this particular version. After that we will apply the image. Then we will again create two set of tests, A test and B test. Word will be X. Now we will use the image. Let this is your image. Here we will mention. So again we will perform the testing, A-B testing, and then again we will get some results. So why is in that, we have to perform test in a variation mode. We cannot like take all the things in a one go. We have to perform each and every word in a different variations. Why is in that, we can increase our revenue and profitability. Also learn what works. What work means we can get what things are working better way by using the A-B testing. And data driven decision making, it means we are not going to make any assumption, because these are all the data driven. Because we are creating this website, so we are performing the A-B testing and we are sending all the like mail, or we are going some online marketing. So by using that, we are like collecting all the data. So this is a data driven process where we can use A-B testing. We use the in digital optimization. Let's, if we want to like optimize our digital platform, like in current scenario, most of the company who are currently running in offline mode, they want to perform their business in the online mode, or they want to do some more digitization in their company so that they can promote their sale, they can boost their profitability. So why in that we use the A/B testing, that way we perform the digital optimization. So wherever we want to do the digital optimization, we can perform the A/B testing, like online experimentations and all website experiences like headlines, audio, video, subject line, product description, content depth. So these things we can use in our A/B testing if we want to perform the website experience, like paid advertising, where if we want to do some paid advertising, we can use the A/B testing in mobile apps. Like we want to test our app is working or not, like this is your app, okay, you perform this app. So what you will do, you will create a different versions, A version, B version, C version. What you will do, you will send this particular app version to a different set of community, different set of community, and different set of community. So why in that, you will get some analysis, you will get some results that how is your app performing. So in this way you can get a better mobile app and the marketing campaign like offline, online, emails. So here we can also use the A/B testing. So in current scenario, you can say that in most of the cases we use the A/B testing. So A/B testing is a very important terms in the statistics, which is being currently used in many industries, in basically in digital industry. It is drastically improving the performance. What to test in A/B testing? So basically what we can test in the A/B testing. So in A/B testing, we can test the website pages, page flow, element, like this is your web page. We can test the web page, what is the page flow, like this is your website, there are the different pages. So we can test the page flow, how the page flow will work to a different set of users. So this way we can test the A/B testing and different element, like different like subject in this particular web pages. So we can also test those elements inside the web pages, which element will perform in a better way. So that element we can choose by using the A/B testing. Business model, let's you want to run some business, for that you make some business model. So let's this is your business model A and this is your business model B. So you can test this business model by using the A/B testing. You can also test this business model B by using the A/B testing. Backend functionality or algorithm, let's this is your Amazon website. So in Amazon website, so whenever the user like land at any product page, so we can get the user behavior, how much time this user is taking on that particular product page, or what is the strike rate and how much time he stay, or whether he will purchase or not. So these type of the things we can get the by using the A/B testing. Also new product and services, let if we want to launch any product or services, so we can use the A/B testing during this product launch, or any we want to create any new services. So to test that particular services or to test that particular product, we use the A/B testing, that which product, which way we can improve our sales of that particular product. So this way we can perform the A/B testing. How to do the A/B testing? So to perform the A/B testing, first we need to set our goals, what we need to test. Let we want to test the web page. So first we need to set our goal that we want to improve the web page strike rate. The customer should stay long time at this particular web page. This is our goal. Select the goal that you will test. So this goal we have to test, that we want the customer should stay more time at this particular web. So these things we need to test. Define primary success matrix. We need to define a primary success matrix that customer should stay at least 2 seconds or at least 5 seconds at that particular page. So we need to prepare some threshold. What threshold we have to set before the testing? Choose the best A/B testing tool, because so there are many tools by using that we can perform the A/B testing. So we need to select the appropriate testing tool as per our data. After that we will create different variations. Let's we want to test this web page. So what we will do, first we will test the formatting of this web page, then in the second variation we will use some images in the web page, then we will use some headlines of this web pages, then we will use some bottom, how the bottom will look like. So this way we can create a different set of variations during the A/B testing. Then after that, what we will do, we will document all those things and we will document all the results. Then after that we will analyze the result and we will get some output. By in that output we will get whether our result are getting as per our expected matrix or not. So after that we will finalize our AV testing, and if the AV testing will not perform better, then what we will do, we will repeat the process again, we will do some changes. So this way we perform the AV testing. That's it from my side for today. Thank you for watching my video. Have a nice day.